In the fifth round of the 2017 NHL Entry Draft, the Vancouver Canucks drafted Kristoffer Gunnarsson, who was an overager at the time, but was a player who the Vancouver Canucks had their eye on because of his professional experience and, let's just say, an interesting showcase at the World Juniors. Kristoffer Gunnarsson is a guy who's 6'1", 205 pounds, left-handed defenseman. And he's a player who a lot of Vancouver Canucks fans saw a little bit of potential, a tiny, tiny bit of potential, when he was drafted, seeing as he had spent the past two seasons going up and down between the Super Elite, the Allsvenskan, and the SHL. Gunnarsson was a guy who, in 16 and 17, spent a few games with the Frölunda Indians of the SHL. This is arguably one of the SHL's stacked teams. And he was playing, he was one of their top six defenders, and he spent a good portion of his draft plus 1 year, which was the year we drafted him, in the SHL and international tournaments, as well as the Allsvenskan. And it's very interesting to note just exactly what Gunnarsson has accomplished, because he spent the entirety of 17-18 with the Frölunda Hockey Club, so now we have an actual gauge of what he's able to accomplish at the pro level. And it's kind of interesting, because throughout three seasons in playing for Frölunda, from 2015-16 to 16-17 to 17-18, he's played a total of 69 SHL games over the span of 3 years, and he has 0 points. How is that even possible? How do you get 0 points playing for a stacked Frölunda team over the span of 3 years? This team's got Rasmus Dahlin in it. This is the defensive core led by Dahlin. The center core, Joel Lundqvist, Henrik Lundqvist's brother, team captain of Team Sweden at the Olympics or whatever. The Frölunda Indians have been legitimately stacked for the past few years. And Kristoffer Gunnarsson comes in here as one of their top six defenders, plays 69 games, and has nothing. That takes skill. How do you have 0 points on a stacked SHL team? Oh boy, okay, I just needed to get that off of my chest. I don't even know how that's possible. But he did have an interesting showcasing at the World Juniors in 2017. He was 19, turning 20 years old back then, which is why he was playing for the World Juniors. In the 7 games that he played, he got himself 1 assist. Okay, the rest of Team Sweden's U20 team. Yeah, let's talk about that. In his other international tournaments playing for the U20 team, 20 games played for Gunnarsson, 1 goal, 1 assist. Okay. Gunnarsson has legitimately not scored a single goal playing for any team other than Team Sweden since his Allsvenskan loan in 2016-17 playing for the IK Oskarshamn. What? Okay, let's just actually take a look at Gunnarsson. He's a player who is, let's just say, a defensive defenseman. That's really what he is. And the fact that he has played for so many games with the Frölunda Indians in the past year is kind of a testament to just how much they legitimately rely on him. Let's just say that. You don't get 46 games played for Frölunda as a defenseman without being of some sort of value, right? So it's fair to establish that he is a player that they use, and he is a player that they would have in the lineup. But what exactly is Gunnarsson's potential? What does he project to be? And what exactly does he offer the Vancouver Canucks? Well, the fan-sided article, the Canuck Way, they had Gunnarsson as a top four AHL defenseman, which, you know, that's fair from a fifth-round pick. But Gunnarsson really hasn't necessarily been in a position to really show off all of his assets. He's played a total of 69 SHL games in the regular season and 14 in the playoffs and 0 total points. A plus-minus of 3 in the regular season, and a plus-minus of minus 1 in the playoffs, Gunnarsson really isn't necessarily a player who has been exhibiting the greatest of values here for an NHL team looking at a player who might become one of their own. Gunnarsson is a defensive defenseman who hits people. He's not afraid to step up his game, he's not afraid to make a good breakout pass. That's what Elias Pettersson said about Gunnarsson, like, he's fearless. He won't back down from a challenge, and he's got a good, quick breakout pass. But my question is, how does he have a good breakout pass if he's not getting any assists? You don't breakout pass once to Joel Lundqvist, who goes in on a breakaway and scores, or you breakout pass to Leah Anderson, who feeds Joel Lundqvist in the front of the net. that doesn't happen for him. And it's crazy to me how it doesn't. It's just so weird. This is the mysterious case with Kristoffer Gunnarsson right here. And I just have no idea what exactly the potential is here. Now, of course, if Gunnarsson comes into camp, he becomes the best defenseman there. He makes the team next year, and he becomes an instant top two. Even if he gets 0 points, if he doesn't allow a goal in his life, I'm okay with that. But that's pretty unlikely now, isn't it? Man, it's just weird. It's just weird, guys. I wanted to take this opportunity to talk about Gunnarsson because it's just weird. Looking at the past Canucks draft picks, 2017 draft was amazing, but Gunnarsson, I have no idea where to even gauge him or even begin to gauge him within the Canucks radar. Hope you guys enjoyed this video here, plus these are all saying gaming, and bye.